Sometimes convenience comes with a cost. Welcome to Watch Mojo. And today we're counting down our picks for the 10 dark secrets Amazon doesn't want you to know.
And now you got your Amazon. And the milkman's come back. And none of you are safe.
For this list, we're looking at some sinister supposed facts about this retail giant.
Looks like I got a couple packages from Amazon for you.
Oh, is that so?
Number 10, spend, spend, spend.
A record-breaking $1.5 billion worth of merchandise is expected to have been ordered online today, and no one ships more orders than Amazon.
If you're an Amazon fan, one of the things you probably like most about the site is how inexpensive everything seems. Why would you buy dish soap from a local store when you can get it cheaper on Amazon and have it shipped to your house for free? But the reality is, Amazon allegedly has its sellers raise the price of items that are being sent to Prime members to make up the cost of free shipping. According to more than one lawsuit, with the use of one-click ordering, they can convince you to shop without overthinking your purchase.
They say this is the hot video game, I'm gonna order it.
Some of these strategies work so well that the average Prime member spends $1,500 a year on the site as of 2016.
Amazon recently added a small army of extra workers in these fulfillment centers just to handle the holidays.
Number 9, they've been accused of spying on you.
Alexa, turn down the thermostat.
Okay, turning down thermostat.
Ready.
Here we go.
Amazon has brought us into the future in so many ways. And with the Alexa virtual assistant, we can feel as if we have a helpful robot in the house like in sci-fi shows.
How are you doing, Rosie?
Just cleaning the rug, ma'am.
She can tell us the weather, answer our pressing trivia questions, and of course, reorder items from Amazon for us.
Echo is connected to Alexa, a cloud-based voice service, so it can help out with all sorts of useful information right when you need it.
But following an inquiry from U.S. Senator Chris Coons in 2019, Amazon confirmed that they keep recordings of users' voices until they're manually deleted by the user. And the text transcripts of those recordings may be kept forever. We can only imagine how useful it would be for the site to keep track of our likes and dislikes in order to market products to us.
It really is a vacuum in terms of its ability to take as much data as possible, identify it in the hopes of then finding stuff they can sell you.
Number 8, pricing.
Millions of changes per day to the pricing of the items on its site. And some individual items even get more than one price change in a single day.
When you're shopping on Amazon, you'll probably notice that there's the sale price, which is what you'll pay, and the list price. The list price is supposedly the retail cost of the product.
Amazon has the shipping and ordering process down to an exact science.
But evidence has shown that these numbers are often overblown by vendors in order to make it seem like items are being sold at a steeper discount. The Canadian version of the site was forced to pay the Competition Bureau a $1 million penalty fine and an additional $100,000 in costs for these dishonest marketing tactics.
There are going to be a lot of deals online right up until Cyber Monday.
Number 7, Amazon's effect on the publishing industry.
It's a company known for its competitiveness and its secrecy.
Remember when Amazon was mainly for buying books? Now they've expanded, but in the process, they've changed the publishing industry forever. Many high-profile authors, including Stephen King and John Grisham, were involved in a petition over agency pricing, which demanded that the corporate giant leave room for authors and publishers to make a profit.
How would the ebook pie be split? And how would ebooks be priced? And this disagreement had fundamental repercussions for the rest of the publishing industry.
The petition stated, quote, "We encourage Amazon in the strongest possible terms to stop harming the livelihood of the authors on whom it has built its business. None of us, neither readers nor authors, benefit when books are taken hostage.
No group of authors as diverse or prominent as this has ever come together before in support of a single cause. Collectively, we have sold more than a billion books. Amazon's tactics have caused us profound anguish and outrage."
Not only that, but Amazon controls which books appear on its sales rankings. And in 2009, the retailer came under fire when it categorized LGBTQ writings as adult, thereby stripping them of the all-important sales rank.
So I think one thing the dispute displayed prominently is how important and powerful Amazon has become on the book publishing landscape.
Number 6, environmental record.
Amazon alone shipped over 5 billion packages through Prime in 2017. And in 2019, announced they are expanding their one-day delivery service to over 10 million products.
having items shipped to you in 2 days may be convenient for shoppers, but it can take a significant toll on the environment. Anyone who's ordered from Amazon knows how much packaging is involved with any individual item, with small products often arriving in outside boxes.
Now, for the most part, if you compare online shopping with, say, driving to the store, online shopping has a smaller carbon footprint. But there's a catch. It's only better for the environment if you don't get rush delivery.
Employees of the company have protested their climate policy, making demands such as aiming for zero emissions by 2030 and leaving behind their connections to oil and gas companies. Amazon also provides funding to climate change deniers like libertarian think tank the Competitive Enterprise Institute and Republican politician Jim Inhofe.
Our group of Amazonians here, we've all gathered together so that we can participate in this global climate strike. And really show that Amazonians care about the climate. We want change both from world leadership and from our company leadership. We need to take action to avert the climate crisis.
Number 5, you might not own your Kindle books.
Amazon really has emerged as the premier book retailer.
When you buy an ebook, you probably assume you own it forever, like you would with any other non-digital product. But the reality is a little more complicated. While the Kindle Terms of Service may state that Amazon, quote, grants you the non-exclusive right to keep a permanent copy of the applicable digital content, there have been several instances of books being removed from people's accounts. Many sources have found that if you dig through the fine print, you'll find that you actually are only licensing these books. And that's something that can be taken away at Amazon's discretion.
I think that's sort of a longer term battle that will have to unfold as we see how consumer ebook prices fluctuate.
Number 4, their business practices are creative.
Considering the company hardly had any annual profit until 2016, this represents major growth.
Today, they're earning over $10 billion a year. But in the beginning, Amazon became famous for not turning a profit. Some sources say this was all part of their business model, and that they never intended to make a profit in the first few years of operation.
Companies turning a profit is really interesting in the way that they're doing it, because this is a company that has famously avoided profits, right? They have taken every possible dime of profits and reinvested in the business.
As the theory goes, by not turning a profit, they were able to undercut prices in many different industries, convincing shoppers to switch from brick and mortar shops. As each year passed, their profit margin steadily increased. And while it's still actually modest, they've clearly found a way to earn the big bucks anyway.
It's Amazon, the stock touching new all-time highs.
Number 3, taxes.
Did you pay federal income tax last year? Oh, one of the biggest companies in the world paid none.
Nothing can be said to be certain except death and taxes, right? Well, not for Amazon. In 2017 and 2018, Amazon paid zero federal income tax, despite its billions of dollars of profit. Not only that, but they actually got millions of dollars in refunds. How did they pull this off? In years when they were less profitable, they offset their future taxes, in a move that has brought them plenty of criticism from across the political spectrum.
According to data compiled by the Institute on Taxation and Economic Policy, Amazon had an effective federal tax rate of just 3% over 10 years.
They've also historically avoided charging sales tax whenever they can, which gave them an advantage over other businesses who were forced to charge their customers more.
But one thing is for sure, it's quite normal for some corporations to pay no income tax to the federal government. Is that a normal you're satisfied with?
Number 2, Jeff Bezos owns the Washington Post.
The Graham family sold the Washington Post for $250 million to Amazon founder and CEO Jeff Bezos.
If you're not already worried about Amazon potentially having a monopoly on pretty much everything, consider this. Jeff Bezos owns the Washington Post, one of the most respected daily newspapers in the country. The Post was purchased by Bezos in 2013 for $250 million in cash.
Amazon founder Jeff Bezos sent a thunderbolt through the media world this week with a surprise purchase of the Washington Post.
Technically, Nash Holdings LLC owns the paper, but that is run by Bezos. He's reportedly not involved in day-to-day decision-making, but the fact that Bezos ultimately has control over this major media source is cause for concern to some, notably President Donald Trump, who has accused the Post of lobbying on behalf of Amazon. And if this wasn't enough, Amazon has entered into the world of food and now owns Whole Foods as well.
It's dangerous not to evolve. If you want to ensure your extinction, cease to evolve.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications. Number 1, working conditions.
Hundreds of employees on 0 hours contracts are subjected to a regime described as horrendous and exhausting.
By now, you've surely seen reports on the working situations facing Amazon employees on a daily basis, highlighting the supposedly intense physical conditions and unrealistic targets. In 2019, The Daily Beast reported that there had even been suicide attempts by Amazon factory workers. All of these issues and more have led employees to strike in several notable cases.
Plus, over the years, Amazon has faced criticism from workers over their willingness to accommodate basic human needs, like using the bathroom.
Amazon has responded to all of these claims by making an effort to raise the company's minimum wage to $15 an hour. But at the same time, they eliminated bonuses and stock awards for hourly workers.
There is definitely a sense from people that we talk to that Amazon does not really care about their personal lives. You can't reveal any weaknesses or you will be in trouble.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from WatchMojo, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.